Then I saw another angel flying in the midst of heaven, having the everlasting gospel to preach to those who dwell on the earth, to every nation, tribe, tongue, and people.
Good morning, and once again,
Happy Sabbath, Church!
We are now on our Sabbath celebration of the 10 Days of Prayer program, which took place from January 5 to 15.
We are indeed so much blessed to worship and pray to God together, even through virtual online.
This gave us the opportunity to take a break from this busy world, to talk to God and to plead for His forgiveness.
Today, we will be sharing the title, the main verse, and the key thought of each day's prayer program.
The Three Angels' Call to Prayer.
Day 1. The Urgency of Prayer.
How much more will your Heavenly Father give the Holy Spirit to those who ask Him? Luke 11:13.
In this message, Jesus urges us to ask for the Holy Spirit, to plead for the Spirit, to seek the Spirit's blessing with our whole heart, not because He is unwilling to give it, but because we are unprepared to receive it. That's why He invites us to seek Him for the power to accomplish the task before us.
Day 2. The Everlasting Gospel and Prayer.
Revelation 14:6. Then I saw another angel flying in the midst of heaven, having the everlasting gospel to preach to those who dwell on earth, to every nation, tribe, tongue, and people.
The heart of this message is the everlasting gospel. This is the good news of Christ's self-sacrificial life, His loving ministry, His atoning death, His dramatic resurrection, His interceding high priestly ministry, and His glorious second coming. We are encouraged to pray together for the spiritual revival to take place in our own lives, preparing us for the final climactic events of Earth's history.
Day 3, God's Mission and Prayer, Part 1.
Acts 1:8. But ye shall receive power after that the Holy Ghost is come upon you, and ye shall be witnesses unto me both in Jerusalem and in all Judea and in all Samaria and unto the uttermost part of the earth.
We should pray as earnestly for the descent of the Holy Spirit as the disciples prayed on the day of Pentecost. If they needed it at that time, we need it more today. That's why we are challenged to seek God together in prayer for this mighty outpouring of His Spirit.
Day 4. God's Mission and Prayer, Part 2.
Colossians chapter 1, verses 3 through 6. I will be reading from the New International Version. We always thank God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, when we pray for you, because we have heard of your faith in Christ Jesus and of the love you have for all God's people, the faith and love that spring from the hope stored up for you in heaven and about which you have already heard in the true message of the gospel that has come to you. In the same way, the gospel is bearing fruit and growing throughout the whole world, just as it has been doing among you since the day you heard it and truly understood God's grace.
We need to look constantly to Jesus, realizing that it is His power which does the work. While we are to labor earnestly for the salvation of the lost, we must also take time for meditation, for prayer, and for the study of the Word of God. Only the work accomplished with much prayer and sanctified by the merit of Christ will in the end prove to have been efficient for good.
Day 5. The Obedient Lifestyle and Prayer.
1 John 5:14 and 15. And this is the confidence that we have in Him, that if we ask anything according to His will, He heareth us. And if we know that He heareth us, whatsoever we ask, we know that we have the petitions that we desired of Him.
The three angels' messages call us to a life of obedience. This message reminds us that we become overcomers in the Christian life when we focus on Christ's power, not our weakness. Let's claim the promise of 1 John 5:14 and 15. And as we claim this promise by faith, Jesus will do marvelous things and strengthen us to live godly lives as we prepare for His soon return.
Day 6. Confidence in the judgment and prayer.
Ephesians chapter 1 verses 3 to 5. It says, "Blessed be the God and the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us with every spiritual blessings in heavenly places in Christ." Verse 4, "Just as He chose us in Him before the foundation of the world, that we should be holy and without blame before Him in love." Verse 5, "Having predestined us to adoption as sons by Jesus Christ to Himself, according to the good pleasure of His will."
The urgency of the judgment hour message leads us to a deep relationship with Christ. We long to honor His name and do nothing that would tarnish His reputation. We need not fear for the judgment, for Christ is our advocate, our trial attorney, and our judge. That's why our prayer is for us to examine our hearts and ask God to reveal anything not in harmony with His will. Let us ask Him to cleanse us from those deep and hidden sins, and then thank Him for His grace, His forgiveness, and His power to overcome. Most of all, let us thank Him for Jesus.
Day 7. The three angels' messages, the Sabbath and prayer.
This time I will be reading Isaiah 56:5-7. "To them I will give within my temple, and its walls a memorial and a name better than sons and daughters. I will give them an everlasting name that will endure forever. And foreigners who bind themselves to the Lord to minister to Him, to love the name of the Lord, and to be His servants, all who keep the Sabbath without desecrating it and who hold fast to my covenant. This I will bring to my holy mountain and give them joy in my house of prayer. Their burnt offerings and sacrifices will be accepted on my altar, for my house will be called a house of prayer for all nations."
The Sabbath reminds us that we were created for a purpose. The Sabbath reminds us to rejoice in His love, rest in His care, and glory in the Christ who paid such a high price for our salvation.
The Sabbath also reminds us that we are not alone in a desolate world of sorrow. The Sabbath also reminds us of the gift of salvation.
The Sabbath is a call to prayer, a call to praise, and a call to proclaim His goodness. The Sabbath is a day of thanksgiving.
Day 8, the fall of Babylon and prayer.
Revelation 18 verses 1 and 2. "I saw another angel came from heaven. This one had great power, and the earth was bright because of his glory. The angel shouted, 'Fallen, powerful Babylon has fallen and is now the home of demons. It is the den of every filthy spirit and of all unclean birds and every dirty and hated animal.'" Yes, we are so blessed because these 10 days of prayers will always remind us to be ready, especially preparing people to heaven. God bless.
The second angel's message sounds an urgent appeal to prayer in at least three areas. First, it calls us to be faithful in Christ and in His word. Second, this message calls us to a faith that can stand the test of trial. And third, These messages call us to invite our friends into a deep relationship with Jesus and an understanding of Revelation's truth for this final hour.
Day 9, the mark of the beast and prayer.
Revelation chapter 19 verses 1 to 5 it says, "And after these things I heard a great voice of much people in heaven saying, Alleluia, salvation and glory and honor and power unto the Lord our God, for true and righteous are his judgments, for he hath judged the great whore which did corrupt the earth with her fornication, and hath avenged the blood of his servants at her hand. And again they said, Hallelujah, and her smoke rose up forever and ever. And the 24 elders and the four beasts fell down and worshipped God and sat on the throne, saying, Amen, Hallelujah. And a voice came out of the throne, saying, Praise our God, all ye his servants, and ye that fear him, both great and small."
The final message of the three angels is a call to earnest, heartfelt prayer. The warning against the mark of the beast in the third angel's message should drive us to our knees in humble submission to Christ, pleading for his Spirit to purge us thoroughly from within and work the miracle of divine grace in our hearts. It should also lead us to pray for our family, friends, and neighbors, that they too will have heart open to Christ's saving last day's message. This message should motivate us to look forward to the day when we will rejoice with Christ around his throne forever.
Day 10, God's people, the remnant and prayer.
Good day, everyone. A word of God from the book of Revelation chapter 14 verse 12. And it says, "Here is the patience of the saints. Here are they that keep the commandments of God and the faith of Jesus."
The three angels' messages have one prime purpose, one singular focus. It is to prepare a people for the coming of Jesus. When we experience difficult circumstances and desperately cling to God's promises, our faith grows. When we saturate our minds with the Word of God, our faith grows. When we acknowledge our lack of faith and earnestly pray for God to increase our faith grows.
Let us ask God to give us endurance as we face the trials of life. Let us pray that He will give us the strength to be obedient to His will in every area of our lives. And let us petition heaven to grant us an increase of faith so the faith of Jesus fills our lives and prepare us for earth's final crisis.
Then one day, we will live with Jesus through all eternity.
Strong night to you. tears of joy and wash my face. For you are my reward. Nothing else compares to you, Lord, my God and my salvation. I'll draw nigh to you. I'll draw. Joy, wash my face.